Bible says here, to everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rent, and a time to sew, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. God bless. Let us just pray together and ask God's blessings upon His word. Gracious Father, we are so thankful, Lord God, that we can be this afternoon. Here this afternoon, in the name of Jesus Christ, entering that throne of grace, in the name of Jesus Christ, thank you for another privilege and honor, Lord God, to deal with your people. Your precious word, Father, your unfailing word. I pray that you'll anoint your word, anoint the thought, Father, anoint the expression, anoint whatever will be said or done, in the name of Jesus Christ. And let your bride, the bride of Jesus Christ, Father God, get blessed this afternoon. Get blessed, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that we can get ready, for the time has come, Lord, for us to leave this place, this world behind, in the name of Jesus Christ. Well, thanks, Lord. Amen and amen. The Lord bless you. So I'm going to deal with you, as I've said, the time has come, friends. The time has come that the world will come to an end. The end of the end has come, says the prophet of God. And I can believe that everybody, if nature knows, the Bible says in the book of Revelation, of Romans 8, nature knows that if the children of God will be set free from this flesh, which the Bible calls the bondage of corruption, they know they will also be set free. Meaning that if nature knows the time has come, everybody should know. Every believer should know, every person on the face should know the time has come for us to leave this world behind. Which means that when, as the Bible says, if there's a time to be born, there's a time to die. This world is a dying, friends. This world is a dying, it's making ready for a new world, a brand new world. And friends, I would like to deal with you this afternoon from the spoken word of God, from the following quotations. The first one will be, Father, the hour has come, preached 1956, the 2nd of October. Just for encouraging to God's people, and as confirmation that the time has come for us to leave this world behind. Praise God. The prophets say, yeah, if there was a time that the time has come for the word to be fulfilled, it's now. This is the day. Seeds have been planted. It's time to take the hoe and get out here and go to cutting, and some of these weeds and things we got grown up. So briars and stingweeds and everything else that's grown up amongst the people, doubters, disbelievers, lukewarm, everything else. It's time for us to get the hoe and chop it out. And there's nothing any better than a two-edged sword of God to cut it with. Friends, I believe that somehow in the question answers, when the prophet started the question answer on the seven seas, he said, we cannot go on with what we have done. In other words, if we were wrong, if we've been off the line, if we've been off the beaten track, friends, we cannot go on like that. Signs like this things that's happening right now is a sign for the world, it's a sign to believer, a sign to everybody. It's time for us to get ready to move out of this world, to get ready for the coming of the Lord. Friends, I'm gonna go over to another quotation, and that is just to encourage God's people this afternoon. Praise God. Amen. Praise His wonderful name. Prophet says here that the great drama, the deed of Jesus Christ, preached the 25th of December 1949. The great drama is set, says the prophet. We are ready now to see great things happen. Praise God. Meaning, everything is set in order. Everything is in place for everything to happen, because it's the end time now, friends. You're going to see things happen as you will never see. You know what really it excites me? It's about the thing that the prophet refers to. The thing that's holding back the coming of Christ now. That is the power that lays dormant in the church now. Meaning, there will not be a second coming unless that power will be released amongst the people of God, amongst the believers, praise God. The prophet says here, the church has been brought from the cradle. Right, that's right. Pentecostal rocked it down yonder a few years ago. Back there, while the people throw stones and make fun and laugh at them, but she has grown to maturity now. Praise God. The hour is here. Praise God. That's what I'm interested in, to see God's church coming together. Praise God. We've been beat out here. We've been beat out there. But the hour is coming when God is throwing the blanket around us to draw us all in, friends. For the enemy is at the gate. Friends, I'm telling you this afternoon, it's about time that God's people gonna be assembled together. Praise God, we've been separated. There's been discord amongst the believers, but God's gonna pull us together. Amen. I believe it with all my heart. I'm gonna go over to the other quotation. Praise God. Prophet says here, the hour has come, the time had come in Babylon where they laughed God to scorn. In other words, when people laughed at God, when people laughed at the children of God, they can carry on like that. They can carry on with that. But a time will come that thing will be stopped. And it's time that God's going to stop that thing, because the power of God is going to raise up, friends. The thing is what it reminds me what happened to Joseph. Joseph was actually jailed. When you are jailed, when you are in prison, friends, you can do nothing. You just to yourself, amen. But Joseph is a type of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. But the thing is, what I want to say, when Joseph, hallelujah, was raised, was released from that prison, from that jail, friends, hallelujah, he rose to the palace as the second man in charge. And this is what's going to happen one of these days. God, hallelujah, gonna pull people, amen, out of prison, out of the prison houses, amen, out of ourselves, and gonna release us, amen. But before the rapture is gonna take place, friends, it's gonna be a power. It will be displayed. Amen. I just want to quote something quickly. The prophet say, the power that will be released at that time, amen, toothache, cancer, will be like a toothache compared to that power that is coming. Friends, and I just want to complete this quote here. Prophet said, they made fun of the Hebrew children. They laughed at them. They told them they was old fogies and everything. They ought to be modern, but they stayed put. Friends, brothers, sisters, believers, stay put, amen. Stand for the message. Live for the message, amen. But the prophet say, God respects that staying put, amen. And God will respect any man, anybody who's sincere with this message, friends, amen. And they said, they laughed at them. They threw them in jail like Joseph. They done everything to them. But finally, the time come for God to speak. One of these days, friends, God is going to speak through men and women, sons and daughters of God. According to Romans 8, the Bible says nature is moaning, waiting, groaning for the manifestation of the sons of God. They're going to speak the word. Amen. And it will create itself, says the prophet. Then we read further on. He showed his power. He was able to deliver them from a fiery furnace. He showed his power when the time come. Friends, God will not display or show his power if it is not time yet. But the time has come, friends. Nature even knows. The whole world knows something's got to be manifested. You know what it is? It is that power that lays dormant. Praise quiet. It lays dormant in Chestnut. That power will be manifested, friends. I'm going to finish with the last quote. Praise the Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Amen. Bible says here, Prophet says here in the message, the third Exodus message. Hallelujah. And this is what we are seeing all around us. I have referred to the Amorites the last time that I was encouraging the believers. Prophet say, but the thing is cursed. What is cursed? The Amorites. The sin has been heaped up. Amen. And it continually is cursed. It was cursed since the very Nicene Council at Nicaea, Rome. Been cursed ever since. But God has let the iniquity fill up until the time of the Amorites is about fulfilled. Praise God. Friends, don't you think, don't you agree with that? Don't you think it's about time for us to leave this world behind? As the songwriter says, this world is not my home. I'm just passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. I'm going to finish here now. The prophet say, and now anybody with spiritual understanding, remember, I keep quoting, spiritual understanding. You can see that the iniquity of this nation and every nation, friends, I believe, is filled up. She's organized and reorganized and organized and organized, and now she's confederated and joining with something else. The iniquity is filled up. It, praise God, it's time for an exodus. It's time for a calling out to the promised land. Not the promise, just another country to go to, friends, no. But a home. That God's gonna place this power in to the hands of men and women who has been sincere, who has been desperate. Friends, I'm telling you, God is obligated to manifest his power through such men, through such women. May God bless you. Amen. Let's pray together and thank God for his word. Amen. Gracious Lord, we thank you, Lord God Almighty, that once again, Father, we come to the end of this encouraging moment, time for your people, Father. Most probably all over the world, I don't know, Father. But it's, praise God, our opportunity, Father, to convey the message, Father. One of these days, we won't have this privilege. As we have just read, Father, from the spoken word, there will be a confederation of churches. We'll be stopped preaching the word. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you will get your people, your children, ready, desperate, sincere, Lord, for the great exodus, for the homegoing time, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Would you bless this word? Would you bless this few words that has been uttered now, Father, through the mouth of your servant, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, with thanks, Lord. Amen. And amen. The Lord bless you.